Good morning, church. What is going on? We miss you guys so much. It's just so weird again that we're in lockdown again, but you know what? We know that God is still moving, God is still present, and God is just going to just come through like a rushing wind. I'm Nick, and I'm just so honored and privileged to be in your house this morning, wherever you're watching the service. We just want you just to keep being active in the comments section. Just give it a like, give it a thumbs up, give it a share. Just I'm just here to let you guys know what's going on in church at the moment. There is so much happening. We are so lucky that this is going on right now. So I just wanted to go in quickly to what happened this week. It was the Global Care Mobile Supermarket Initiative. On Wednesday, we had our first farmers market with Global Care Initiative in partnership with Food Bank Victoria. And we had an amazing opportunity to extend God's love to individuals and families that are in particular need during this time. A massive shout out to our Global Care volunteers who, from all the reposts we've been seeing, we've been blown away and privileged to have reached the community as we have, and we're looking forward to doing it again in August. So good. We've also, in the Philippines, as you may or may not be aware, Centerpoint Church in Philippines has another new location Bulit Sapul, Papanga. And we are so excited in Australia that we get to share in blessing and being a part of God reaching a new community. We want to thank those who have already given through our release offering towards the Philippines as we have started building. If you would like to play a part and would like to be a part in this year's release offering, please do so by filling out one of our release offering cards, and together let's support what God is calling us to do. She is Sisterhood, Monday the 26th of July at 7:30 via Zoom this time, guys. So it's cancelled in person, it'll be via Zoom. If you do want more information on this, please DM Pastor Trish and she'll give you all the information in relation to this. And just keep sharing with your friends and get everyone invited. So we also got our Melton interest meeting this week. And just wanting to just share a bit on what God is doing. It's just a massive shout out to our Melton crew. They're doing an amazing job and God is moving by His Spirit. And next Sunday we have our second interest meeting at 4 p.m. Last month we had over 80 people came out, and 70% of those were not from Centerpoint Church and were unchurched people. So we are so charged, we're so excited for what God is going to be doing. And, you know, just keep praying and supporting and championing Nick and Kim on, because they're doing an amazing job out there in Melton, and so is their team. So good. Connect groups, our connect groups have started again. You know, each week we have connect groups, and at this time, they are online. So if you want to be a part of a connect group, please just send a DM to our Instagram page or our Facebook, and we can just link you with the connect group that you guys would want to attend. Coming up in August, on the 10th of August, we have Alpha starting. So think about who you can bring to hear to Alpha to hear about God and see the world in His light of His perspective and discover why He sent Jesus to us. We also have Growth Track coming up for anyone who would like to know about the mission of Centerpoint Church and getting involved in playing an integral part of the church. Awesome. So we're going to come into a time of giving. If you want to look to the screens, there'll be ways that you can give. I just wanted to really bring a thought. And, you know, right now we see everywhere around us in the media, we see it on our Facebook streams, on our Instagram streams. One thing in our state, in our country and around the world, one thing I know is people are struggling right now. You know, we're going through a time that is unseen before. You know, we've been through lockdowns before, you know, lockdown 1, 2, 3, 4, but this one is different. I work in the mental health sector and I just see people are just struggling more and more during this lockdown. I just want to encourage everyone in our church today, if we want to make an impact in our community, if we want to make an impact to a lost and dying world, we need to continue to have that spirit of generosity so we can impact the lives for good and for God. You can already see with your generosity, we have already impacted the community through Global Care. We have impacted our city within Melton, even Tullamarine, and we also impacted in another country within Philippines. But church, this is just the beginning. That spirit of generosity, let's continue to catch that spirit. Let's continue to just invest into what God is doing through this church, through these four walls, through outside these four walls. Let's continue to invest in God's kingdom. Amen. So I'm just going to pray for the offering, and we just Father God, we just thank you for this morning, what you're doing. Yes, we are in lockdown, but you know what, Lord? You still reign. You are still the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. You are the Alpha and Omega. You are the lover of our soul. And this morning, we just want to give you the glory. We want to give you the honor. We would just want to give you and dedicate our finances and dedicate. We want that spirit of generosity over our whole church to just bless others. We want to make your love known in this place, Lord God. So we just want to thank you. We give you all the honor, all the praise in Jesus' name. And everyone at home said, amen. Awesome.
Good morning, everyone. So good to be with you all this morning. I'm just going to share a quick thought with you guys about the Holy Spirit from the book of Psalms. I love the book of Psalms because it actually means songs of praise. So instead of actually singing praises this morning, we're going to read it together. So from Psalm 109, verse 7 to 12. I can never escape from your spirit. I can never get away from your presence. If I go up to heaven, you are there. If I go down to the grave, you are there. If I ride with wings of the morning, if I dwell by the farthest oceans, even there your hand will guide me and your strength will support me. I could ask the darkness to hide me and the light around me to become night. But even in the darkness, I cannot hide from you. To you, the night shines as bright as day. Darkness and light are the same to you. I love this psalm because it's actually about the omnipresence of God. How comforting is it to know that the Holy Spirit is with us always? The Holy Spirit is there to be our comforter, our biggest support, and our guide. Especially in such a time as this, whatever it is you're going through, if you're feeling alone, if you feel like you're in a dark place, just know that the Holy Spirit is always with you. As it says in that scripture, but even in the darkness, I cannot hide from you. To you, the night shines as bright as day. Darkness and light are the same to you. It's telling us that he's always there. He sees us. He's always with us throughout any situation. And he's always there any time of the day, any time of the night, any season or any place. So this morning, I just wanted to encourage you guys to declare this promise over your lives. Know that you're never alone. The Holy Spirit's always with you. Fix your eyes on him and listen to that sweet, still voice of the Holy Spirit. Thank you so much for listening, guys. Now I'm going to pass it on to Pastor John to share more about the Holy Spirit. Thank you.
Thanks, Nat. You're going to take a snapshot first. So good. Awesome. What a way to begin our service and our time together with finding out what's happening in around the church. Amazing things are happening because we continue being the church. No matter where we are, whether it's in person or we are scattered. And you know what? The fact of the matter is that during the week we do scatter. And in actual fact, it's been a forced scatter. But let's continue being the church. And I love hearing some of the stories that I'm hearing. And I want to encourage each and every one of you to continue to reach out to one another, as Nick has encouraged us, to continue being connected. You know what? A word, a kind word, someone that you send a text to or you call up, just means you're thinking about them. The power of the invite. I know right now it is strict lockdown. But you know what? Let's believe here in Victoria, at least on Tuesday night, midnight, we're coming out of that and we'll continue to roll out. But let's face this one truth. The fact is that no matter what season we're in, whether we're in a valley or at the height of our mountain, God is still the same. He doesn't change. And you know what? Right now, if you see you're in a storm And this lockdown 5.0 is creating, yes, it is creating more havoc than the last one. It seems to increase. But let me tell you, the Bible says where sin abounds, grace abounds much more. So there's more grace for us, but we need to be able to receive that. And this morning I pray by the power of the Holy Spirit that your hearts will be open. Can we just pray together before we get into today's series of the Holy Spirit? Father God, I just thank you. I thank you for the opportunity to continue to come together. It doesn't matter where we are, whatever place we find ourselves. As Natalie said, God, you're omnipresent. Lord, you can be with us here in the church building in Tullamarine and in the houses and cars and wherever you are, wherever people are listening this morning. And Lord, we just bless you, God. We pray for hearts this morning. Lord, that we will just be quiet and still. And Lord, I pray, Lord, right now for this 25 minutes, Lord, that we would just have an ear to hear what your Spirit has to say. Lord, this morning we put aside all the craziness that is outside our doors. Lord, of what's happening right now. Lord, you're in control of that. And Lord, actually, we surrender it to you. Lord, we surrender these times to you. And Lord, more importantly, we surrender our heart to you. We open up the posture of our lives for you, Holy Spirit, to speak to us this morning. That's our prayer. And I'm going to go with what Nick said. And everybody said, amen and amen. Please continue to comment, share those emojis, send your love through the online stream. Share as well. It's important to share. You know, we had a testimony last week of someone sharing the stream, and one of their friends just inquired, and they were able to lead that person to the Lord through a sharing of a stream. Right now, there are people that are looking and finding for things to do because there's not much we can do. But let me tell you, God's word still is going out, and it's such an opportunity we have via the technology we have. And I just want to give a shout out to our guys that are here today and being able to send this through to us. Well, last week we talked about the person of the Holy Spirit and how he comes and speaks to us through revelation, through illumination, you know, through inspiration. We talked about that the week before. We talked about, Pastor Trish talked about the person of the Holy Spirit, that he's a real person. He's a he is God, and he's here for us. And you know what? Last week we left off with the question, because we were going to look at what does a Spirit-led life look like. You know, you can talk to certain people and they have a view about what that looks like. And today we're going to be exploring that thought around the fruit of the Holy Spirit. What does the fruit of the Holy Spirit look like in a person? What is the evidence that comes from a person's life who is led by the Holy Spirit? And the Bible's clear about that. And what the Bible says is that as a person, we can be led either by the Spirit or by the flesh, the carnal mind. And we're going to be talking about that. You know, one life is regenerated and the other one is not. Well, in other words, what does that mean practically? It means that our soul can be led either by the Holy Spirit, which is a life of enjoyment of peace and overflow according to the goodness of God and the promises and the plans that he has for us, and or we can be led by the flesh, the carnal mind, which is gratifying selfish desires and moving in the opposite direction of God's best for our life. But before we get into this, I want us to really establish what it means when the Bible says that we can be led by the flesh, because it doesn't mean the physical body. And I want to establish that, and let's have some, I guess, some biology lessons or a lesson in human anatomy. Can we do that for now? Because the flesh in the Bible has nothing to do with that portion of meat that is under your skin. That's called the physical body. And in fact, the physical body is the house, you're looking at him right now, that the spirit and the carnal mind live in. Our soul is encased in this body. And the fact is that most people, and I'm talking about, let's talk about Christians, most people never get to the place where they understand their spiritual anatomy. They don't understand their spiritual body. It's so much of a life that we look and see what's in front of us and we live according to that. But today, I just want to spend some time about learning about the parts of our spiritual being which makes us, because this is so, so important with what we're going to be talking about today. First of all, there's the body. And that is, again, this physical body. It's a living organism made up of skin, blood, water, oxygen, bone, muscle, depending how big that is, depending how much muscle you have. But the reality is that's what we know as a human being. If we were to ask someone, what is a human being? That's what they would describe, that kind of body. And in fact, that is who we are. We're a human being. But then there are these other parts that really we need to focus on this morning, which when we bring how the Holy Spirit leads us, we'll understand in the areas that He's leading us. Does that make sense? I hope I haven't lost you. Secondly is the soul. The soul is who we are, our identity, made up of mind, heart, and will. You know, our mind, our think tank, is part of our soul, that we think on things. We think on the Word of God. We think on what people say to us. And then what happens is we get emotional about those things, whether it be, you know, a strong emotion towards it or against it. It's emotion. It's our heart, passion towards it. Then we have a will. Then we decide the direction that we move in, the area that we're going to focus on. Yes, I've made a decision. This is where we're going, our will. So it's mind, heart, and our will. And that is our spiritual being. Our spiritual being, which lives in the human being, in the person. And that is encased in our body, as I said before. But yet, that being was born in sin. It exists, but is dead to God. Then there's the flesh man. And we're going to be talking a little bit about this, the spirit and the flesh. The carnal man, or the sinful man, as some people know him. And that's the person who influences our soul. This is before we're born again. He influences our soul. And the reason why he does that is because of Adam's disobedience to God right in the very beginning. So before we're born again, there's an influence called the carnal mind, the flesh man. And now, the spirit. So this all makes up the spiritual being, the soul, who we are, that's encased in this body. The spiritual being is, the spirit is the Holy Spirit, who breathes into our soul at the moment we're born again of the Spirit of God. See, we're born again of the Spirit of God. And as soon as we're born again of the Spirit of God, our soul awakens. It becomes alive to the things of God. So we're dead prior to that. We exist. We move around. We do life. But yet, our soul is dead to God. In other words, no relationship with God. But when the Holy Spirit comes in, He breathes life, awakens us to Him, and our vital relationship with God begins. I want to say this before we move on. All of this is a work of God. That's right. He's the one who saves us. But here's the thing this morning. The Bible says, although He saves us, it's the work of the Holy Spirit that brings new birth and new life. If we look on the screens, Titus 3:5 says this. You can read with me. He, being God, saved us not because of the right things we have done, but because of His grace. But here's the thing. He washed away our sins, giving us what? A new birth and a new life. How? Through the Holy Spirit. I want to get that into your spirit this morning. That new birth and new life comes through the Holy Spirit. It's a baptism of the Holy Spirit. And we have a baptism of the Holy Spirit, and we have a baptism of water, and we also have a baptism in the Holy Spirit. We're going to be talking about that down the road in our series. But right now, the work of the Holy Spirit, He's the one that baptizes us in Himself, or it's a baptism of the Holy Spirit when we're born again of the Spirit of God. So, it comes to the question we left off with last week. What does the Holy Spirit produce in a life, in the person's life that he's living in? What are some of the traits? What are the evidences? What is the fruit that the Holy Spirit produces in our lives? Well, again, let's go to the Word of God, and the Word of God will tell us what the Holy Spirit produces. Here's Galatians 5:22. But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in particular. This kind of fruit. You know, you can go to an orange and expect to produce this kind of fruit, an orange tree. You go to an apple tree and you can expect to get apples. But why would you go to an apple tree and expect bananas? I think maybe you're going a bit bananas. So the reality is we've got to realize that the Holy Spirit produces a kind of fruit. And this is what he's saying. He produces this in our lives: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Self-control. Boy, that last one. Self-control. But here's the thing, and this is what I love about the Holy Spirit. This is what I love about our God. He produces it. It's his work in you. It's his life in you. It's his fruit in you. So if he is in you, guess what's going to come out of you? Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, long-suffering, self-control. If he is in you, then what is going to come out of you is what he produces. And this is what he produces. You're going to know what you get. You know, when you go somewhere and you're thinking, oh, gee, they're telling us this, but are we really going to get this? And sometimes you've experienced it. You've gone somewhere and you've been told, oh, look, we're going to give you A, B, and C. But then the experience is D, E, and F, fail. The reality is, when it comes to the things of God and when he speaks his word, what he says is what we're going to receive. That's so good. Galatians 5:25 says this: since we are living by the Spirit, let us follow the Spirit's leading in what? Every part of our lives. Again, I want you to realize this, that you can only follow the Spirit because it's the Holy Spirit that is in you. And since that is in you, we need to allow him to lead us. The fact is that although he is in us, we need to allow him to lead us. And this is where we're going to be starting to paint the picture of the battle that happens within the body, within the physical body of a person's life, in the soul, where there is battle for real estate between the spirit and the carnal man. So, being born again, what's that about? Well, it's more than just an event. It's more than just a status. Oh, I'm born again, or I got born again in 1986. That's amazing. But being born again of the Spirit of God means that there is a Spirit called the Holy Spirit who is God, and he's alive in you. It's a powerful new life. He's given you new birth, and it's a life that the Holy Spirit wants you to enjoy with God. So the challenge that we have, though, is that now that the Holy Spirit lives in us, we need to make a decision. We need to decide whether for the rest of our lives, the challenge is are we going to allow the Holy Spirit to lead us? We've got to give him permission to lead us. And I say this for the rest of our lives, not for the remainder of our lives, for the rest of our lives. Why have I said the rest of our lives? Because the fact is that when the Holy Spirit comes into our life, we come to a place of peace and we come to a place of rest. And all we need to do is allow him to lead us, allow him to guide us, allow him to teach us. These are some of the things that he does. But we must allow him, give him permission to. Why? Because, and this is where we become unstuck. The reason why we need to allow the Holy Spirit to lead us is because the life God intended and has prepared and has so freely given us will not be able to be enjoyed, because if we don't allow him to lead us, guess what? There is an enemy. And he will rob us, the Bible says in John 10, he will rob us of this. The MO of the enemy is to come and steal, to kill, and destroy your faith in this new life. So here's the thing. Sure, I believe in God, but my life will be unfruitful. It will be powerless in today in the way we walk about. You know what COVID has shown me? The challenges that we face. What COVID has shown me is the challenges we face is that God wants you to be a part of Him. God wants you to be a part of Him, and He's given us the Holy Spirit for that to happen. I've got good news. Very, very good news. As much as the enemy can rob us when we don't have the Holy Spirit in our life, leading us and guiding us, the difference is that the enemy, aka Satan, cannot still kill and destroy our lives when the Holy Spirit leads us. When you decide to allow the Holy Spirit to lead you, guess what? Sure, you can be attacked, because in life we do get attacked, but we will not be robbed. The difference is that when the Holy Spirit leads us, we do come under attack, but He is the one that is there to protect us from being annihilated or robbed. Right now, if the Holy Spirit is living in you, and you were to be honest with me, come on, if you were to be honest with me, you would agree at times you would find yourself in opposition to God's Word, to His promises, His purposes for your life. There are times that will happen. And you know what? Today, if that bothers you, it's a good thing. The reason why I say it's a good thing is because if it bothers you, it means that the Holy Spirit is living in you. You say, yeah, what is that? What's with that? Why? Well, if you're born again of the Spirit of God, it's not you that's going against God. It's the carnal mind that is battling against the things of God and is wanting to access or make inroads into the real estate of your life. See, according to the Bible, the spirit and the flesh don't agree. They're at odds with one another. You know, Romans 8, 7 and 8 says that the flesh and the carnal mind are at enmity. They battle against one another. They're at war. And in fact, the flesh cannot please God. So that's why St. Paul tells us that the flesh is selfish. The flesh always is looking to take up space and occupy our mind in opposition to the plans of God for you, because God wants His best for your life. Romans 8, 5 says this, those who are dominated by the flesh think about fleshly things, but those who are governed by the Spirit think about the things that please the Spirit. So here's the thing. You want to win in life? You want to be ahead in life? You want to be what the Bible says, more than an overcomer? Very simple. We've got to choose the right government in our life. We've got to choose the right governor to lead us in life. You know what? Every state has a different premier. In this country, we call them premiers. And depending on the premier, whether you like him or not, whoever's leading your state, you're led by that person. Well, I'm saying today, if we want to win in life, if we want to be able to live in the plans and purposes and the promises of God, let's allow the governor called the Holy Spirit to lead us. Why does Paul say not to mind those things? Because the fact of the matter, to mind those things means this: to entertain, to care for, to give a platform to, or to go after. And today, the Holy Spirit is saying, don't go after those things. St. Paul is saying, don't go after those temporal things. They will fade away. They will bring you to naught. They will let you down. They offer you so much, but the reality is in life, they're temporary. Let's, as a church, come on, let's, as individuals, let's allow God to do what He wants to do in our life and to build us up for influence, to build us up for goodness, to build us up into a place that people come and can enjoy eternity. You know, the reality is, the reason why we are focusing on community, why? Because we want people to know that God's love is for them. You know, why are we about, you know, campuses in different places around not only this city, but, you know, to the ends of the earth? Why? Why a church is so passionate about allowing people to come into a space? Because they want people to know that God is for them, not against them. So Romans 8:6 says this: so allowing your flesh to control your mind leads to death. Meaning to naught, meaning to zero, meaning to what a waste of time. But allowing the Spirit to govern your mind leads to life and peace. I know today who I'm voting for. I know where my vote is going in the ballot. It's going to the government of the kingdom of God, and the one who rules that, the one who's in control of that, the one who governs that on the earth is the Holy Spirit. And today my prayer is that if you have not made Him governor of your life, my prayer is today that you will, so that He will allow, or you will allow Him to flood your life in all the areas, the Bible says, that we are living. You know, at the moment you come to God through believing in the finished work of Jesus, you're born again. That's a spiritual fact. Whether you feel it or you don't, you're born again. Because you're born again of the Spirit of God, as I said earlier. It's a baptism of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit baptizes you. It's His baptism. You're born again of the Spirit of God. And Romans 8:9 says this: but you are not controlled by your sinful nature. Thank God. Come on, those who've received Jesus are not controlled by their sinful nature. Why? You're governed by the Spirit. If you have the Spirit of God living in you. Come on, if you have the Spirit of God living in you, He's the governor. But come on, let's not protest. And I'm not talking about the protests that are happening right now. People, if they don't like where government is taking them, what do? They have the right to protest. And you know what? Out with the placards, out with the flares. And then, as we're seeing right now, though, all hell's breaking loose. And that's the same in the Spirit. We have the governor of the Holy Spirit living in us because we're born again of the Spirit of God, but we're putting up placards in our life. Come on, when He's talking about love, joy, forgiveness, He wants to lead us in that way, we're putting up placards. You know what, we might have an issue with someone, placard, I'm not forgiving them. When He's saying, come on, I'm living in you and I've given you the power to forgive. You know what, placards, oh yeah, you know what, they're just after my money. Come on. He's saying, I've given you a spirit of generosity. Whatever it might be. Oh, yeah, you know what? They did this to me. Placard, I'm not going to let them into my life. But hang on, we did what to Jesus? We crucified Him. But yet He came and He said, come into my life. So I want us to really get this morning, church, what does it mean to be led by the Spirit? Because if we're led by the Spirit, Galatians 5:22 tells us what it means for a person to be led. And remember, those who do not have the Spirit of Christ living in them don't belong to Him at all. We're going to come back to that in a moment. You know, God went to the extreme for you and I to receive the Holy Spirit. You know, He went unto death to purchase soul rights to be in relationship with you. That's right. Jesus hung on a cross so that God would come back into relationship and have soul rights to that relationship. You know, God's a jealous God. And He wants to walk and talk with you every day. Come on, in your family life, in your business life, in your personal life, in your ministry life. Come on, in your friendship circles, in your sporting areas, whatever, wherever you move, He wants to walk with you and talk with you. He wants to have relationship with you. So, He wants to have soul right. Why? Because Adam sold not only his, but our soul rights to the enemy back in Genesis. So God now came with a purpose to have soul right again, and He's given us His Holy Spirit. This is so important, what I'm about to say right now. The person who is governed by the Holy Spirit may at times, for whatever reason, and we don't have time to go into the whatever reason at the moment, but at times find ourselves entertaining illegal swatters. I have. We may find ourselves entertaining illegal squatters. You know, those thoughts, why should I forgive them? Come on, that's entertaining illegal squatter. The carnal mind wants to get me not to express or manifest the fruit of forgiveness. Come on, let's get real this morning. But here's the thing, because the Holy Spirit lives in you, what's the Holy Spirit come to do? He's come to convict you. And as we learned last week, for the Christian, he's come to lead us into righteousness. So he convicts us and helps us with the power to forgive and gets us right standing again. That's what I love this morning. It doesn't matter where you are. If you find yourself having not being led or allowing the Holy Spirit to lead you, right now we can pray and say, Lord, you know what? I've been listening to this illegal squatter. He's paying no rent. Man, you've paid the full price in blood, in sending your son, and I'm allowing this illegal squatter to influence me against your plans and purposes. God is so, so good. So, you know what? If something's bothering you, I know that the Holy Spirit's living in you. Because if unforgiveness didn't bother you, if the way you treat people doesn't bother you, then I know we have a problem. You know, Houston, we got a problem. Absolutely. Heaven, we got a problem. And for the person who has not yet received the Holy Spirit, it's clear. If we go back to Romans 8, 9, B, the second part of that says this, and remember that those who do not have the Spirit of Christ living in them do not belong to Him. In other words, what does that mean? That just means that how can we expect someone who's not born again to actually hear and produce the fruit of the Spirit? It's not possible. It's not possible. So for those people, we know that we're going to share the love of God to them because they yet don't know what it is to be born again of the Spirit of God. But here's the other thing, and this is what I'm going to end on today for us to think about, and I'm going to revisit this next time. But here's the thing. What about, because I know you're thinking this, okay, there are people that aren't yet saved or aren't born again, and then there's the born again person. And I've been talking about there's the born again person that can choose to allow the Holy Spirit to lead them, or if you're not choosing the Holy Spirit to lead you, who's leading you? Here's the thing. You might say, well, what about those that have the Holy Spirit but continue to live according to the flesh? How will I know? Here's the question. How will I know if that's me? How do I know who I am? Well, here's the thing. How you know is dependent on the version of God you believe. How do we test that? Here it is. If the version of God is starting to look more like you, sound like you, love only what you love, agree only with what you agree with, the chances are you've created a God according to your flesh man and according to your carnal person. And I want to say this. How does that happen when the Bible clearly says that we are made in the image of God? Not He's made in our image. We are made in the image of God according to the Spirit. And you know what? This morning, I know the Holy Spirit's been speaking to us. And right now, I don't just want to leave us there. I want to empower you. In fact, God's going to empower you. I can't. But what I can do is join with you and pray. And what we can do today, if you've recognized that, you know what? Being led of the Holy Spirit is maybe, you were thinking, man, I thought it was something different. And you know the Holy Spirit has convicted you and saying, hey, just get back into righteousness. Come on. There's still a journey. We're just beginning. Come on. I want to refresh you. I want to fill you again to overflow. I want to clear the pipes. You know when you want to clear the air? I think sometimes we need to clear the air. We need to clear the air with even our understanding and ask the Holy Spirit to come and do what He does. And this morning, can I join with you? And you know what? You might be in the private of your home. It's best time to do this. Maybe stand up if you like. And I want to pray with you this morning. And this first prayer this morning is for anyone who has not allowed the government of heaven and the governor of the Holy Spirit to lead you. And you know that right now. Can I pray with you? Father God, we thank you that you've given us the Holy Spirit. And Lord, at the moment we received you, Jesus, the Holy Spirit breathed into our life to be born again. And Lord, right now, Lord, I've come to a realization that I haven't allowed you to lead me. But Lord, from now on, from this moment, I want you to lead me. I give the space of my soul to you, to your influence, to your goodness, because you love me, because you died for me, and you sent the Holy Spirit to lead me into all truth. And right now, I receive once again, and in fact, I relinquish over to the Holy Spirit the governance of my soul to lead my life into righteousness. So Lord, I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, right now the Holy Spirit is flooding your soul wherever you are. Just continue remaining open. The Holy Spirit is flooding you. He's saying, come with me. He's saying, the best days are still ahead of you. He's saying, now that you're allowing me to lead, I've got so much that God wants to give. And maybe this morning, you've never received Jesus. So you don't even know what this born again that we've been talking about, born again of the Spirit of God. Well, I want to pray with you as well. And you know what? Sometimes it's like, gee, I don't know everything about this, but I just know that I need what he's talking about. If that's you today, can you raise your hand as well? I'm going to pray with you. And as you raise your hand, all you're saying is, Jesus, I want to know you. I want to know why you died on the cross. I want to know why you sent your son to die so that I now could experience life of peace and an abundance and a life with you right now today. And you know what? When we do that, instantly the Bible says that Jesus receives you and the Holy Spirit comes and fills you. So let's pray together. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you for dying on the cross. And Lord, today I receive you. Lord, I don't necessarily understand everything about you, but Lord, I receive you and I want to begin to walk the journey of life with God. Lord, today I receive the sacrifice of Jesus and I today open myself up to the Holy Spirit to come and fill my life and lead me and guide me from now on till you return in Jesus' name. You know what? If you've done that for the first time, we'd love you to go to our website and tell us that you received Jesus. On our website, there's a form to fill out and we'd love to get in contact with you and help you on the journey, answer some questions, continue this conversation with you. We'd love for you to do that. But as I finish, can I just give us a little bit of a chop out, if I can use that term? You know, if you've been walking with Jesus and you're thinking, man, I don't want to get stuck in this rut again. I don't want to ever be a person that has a pattern that forgets that the Holy Spirit is the one who's there for me, is going to lead me. I want to give you some helps. Is that okay? And we're going to put them up on the screen. The first one is, you got to make time for God daily. It's a daily diet. You know, right now, my wife and I are having a change in diet. She's done it for me. She loves me so much. And we're changing our diet. And it's a daily thing. You know, you can go on those crash diets that you go for 4 weeks really hard. And then 3 months later, you end up the Oompa Loompa again. Let me say this. With God, when you meet Him daily, His diet is absolutely pristine. Something happens when we have daily diet with Him. Then we meditate on what He gives us. Come on. We marinate on that. We digest it. We need to digest it. It's no good just meeting with Him and saying, yeah, great meeting to you, high five, I'm off. That's religion. We're talking about relationship. We're now talking about what he speaks to us about. We digest it. Thirdly, stay in character. What does that mean? Come on, we've learned today who we are. We're a son and daughter of God that is born again, filled with the Spirit of God. That's who we are. So if we're filled with the Spirit of God, who do we need to follow? The director, the governor, the Holy Spirit. Come on, let's lean our ear to the Holy Spirit. Let's remain quiet for a moment. This takes moments. We're not talking about hours of our day. We're talking about moments that we lean to him and allow him, invite him into the day. Lead us, Holy Spirit. Have your way. Whatever comes my way, I know that you're allowing this. And Lord, I want your leading on this. And finally, come on, this is what it's about. Live the performance of a lifetime. Enjoy the day. Come on, even during this time, let's enjoy what God has for us. I know that God is just beginning with some of you in your life. And you know what? Some of you have been journeying with him and thinking, man, I'm at the end. No, there is no end with God. It's called eternity. That's where we are going and heading. But we're living in it right now, and he wants us to enjoy that. Not only yourself. And I want to encourage you, you know, in this time to step out of that isolated space that you find yourself in. Because I know that when you allow the Holy Spirit to lead you, that he would be leading you to somebody else. Sure, there are times that we've got to set aside. There are times that we've got to do that. But I'm talking about daily. I know that God wants you to influence the goodness of God on someone else's life in Jesus' name. Father, we just thank you for today. What an opportunity it is to be alive. Lord, what a day it is to be alive, knowing that you lead us and guide us into all truth, into all righteousness. And Lord, today I pray for everybody that's watching or listening or even taking this via YouTube later on. Father, bless them. Lord, continue to speak to them. People open up themselves to you. And Lord, that we would together continue to enjoy what you're building in Jesus' name, amen. Have a great day. Thank you so much. Come on, let's continue connecting, believing next Tuesday that that's going to, those restrictions are going to go. Pray, spend time, meditate on God's word. And I know that as we do, we're going to rise to prominence. Have a great Sunday in Jesus' name. Bye.